Good afternoon to all. In the last three classes, we discussed the major topics of embedded C. Today, let us understand different types of memory used in embedded system or embedded C. There are two major types of memory. One is code memory, another one is data memory. One is code memory, another one is data memory. So in data memory, we have different types. One is directly addressable internal data memory. So that is 128 bytes. Indirectly addressable internal data memory, it is represented as IDATA. Its size is 256 bytes. Bit addressable internal data memory, that is 16 bytes. It is represented as BData. Next, we have external data memory. Externally, we can connect up to 64 kilobytes of memory, and it is represented as X data. P data refers to paged external data memory. Its size is 256 bytes. Code memory is 64 kilobytes. These are the different types of memory used in embedded C. Now, in order to understand it thoroughly, let me take one previous example. Now this is the example. In this, actually we have written program to convert packed BCD 0x29 to ASCII and display the bytes on port 1 and port 2. Here we have declared three variables x, y, z, and we have used the data types as character. Here we have used the variables x, y, z as a character data type. But we have not mentioned here where to declare these variables. That is, we have not specified whether to declare these variables in internal data memory or external data memory or code memory. So it specifies we are not given instruction in order to declare these variables. In this discussion, first let us understand what happens when we write variable x, y, z here, unsigned character x, y, z. When we execute this statement using compiler, the compiler actually reserves byte by byte memory and gives the name x for first byte, and the name y for second byte, and the name z for third byte, and so on. In case if you declare the variables as int, then int is a 16-bit data type, then it takes 16-bit memory location and assigns the variable what we have given. For example, in this case, instead of character data type. By chance, if I had given unsigned int x, then it takes two successive bytes of memory and gives the name x. Now we understood how it assigns the variable to the memory location. But here we are not specified whether to store these data either in internal data memory, external data memory, and so on. For that reason, we need to understand this. So first, code memory. The memory type code is used to specify that variable is to reside in code memory. If you use the word code, along with the data type, then it makes this variable to reside in code memory. So this is how we should include memory types along with data types. The code memory capacity is 64 kilobyte. Its address ranges from 0000 to FFFFH. This ANCHIPROM is used for storing the programs, that is opcode. And we also know that this code memory cannot be modified while we running or when the microcontroller is executing some program. In assembly level language, we used the code MOVC A, at A plus PC, indexed addressing mode. So here, this instruction is used to read the content of code memory to the accumulator. But in reality, we should not access code memory while the microcontroller is running or executing the program. The way of declaring memory type is like this: character, code, my data. My data is the array name. Here I have stored some letters to the name array, my data, that is communication. Here I have considered the data type as character and the memory type as code. It declares that character array called my data resides in code memory, or communication resides in code memory. Next, let us take data memory. So in 8051, we know that it has 128 bytes of RAM, that is a data memory. The memory type data is used to specify that variable is to reside in directly addressable internal data memory. If we declare some variables by making use of data memory type, we have some advantages. That advantage is, since internal data memory, as the name itself indicates, it is very nearer to controller or arithmetic and logical unit. Since it is very nearer to arithmetic and logical unit, the access time of that memory is very fast. It is 128 bytes on chip RAM with an address starting from 00 to 7FH. We all know it. It has the shortest access time, but the amount of data is limited to 128 bytes. So why this has shortest access time? Because it is located within the microcontroller, or it is very nearer to arithmetic and logical unit, that is ALU. The way to declare data type is like this: unsigned int data z. Here the variable is z. In earlier case, we were writing unsigned int z only. We were not writing data. So here I am explaining data also. So in this case, it assigns or it declares variable z in data memory only. It does not declares in any other memory. So what is the advantage of declaring the variables in a specific memory? We all know that code memory size is 64 kilobyte. In case if we declares thousands and thousands of bytes in code memory, it restricts size of code. Since its capacity is restricted to 64 kilobyte, we should use that code memory in order to store only programs or the code. We should not use that code memory in order to store data or temporary data. For that reason, while writing embedded C program, we should specify memory types so that the variables are declared are stored in a separate memory and the codes or programs are stored in separate memory. So next, let us take second next type of data memory. This is internal data, indirectly addressable internal data, IDATA. The memory type IDATA is used to specify that variable has to reside, variable must be declared in the internal data memory. Indirectly addressable internal data memory. Data is also internal data memory. IDATA is also internal data memory. The difference is it is indirectly addressable internal data memory. We all know that 8051 has 256 bytes of RAM, out of which 0 to 127, that is first 128 bytes of memory, is called directly addressable internal data memory. The next, that is starting from 80 to FF, that is SFR address range, that memory is called as indirectly accessible internal data memory. And hence we can say internal indirectly addressable internal data memory is restricted to 128 bytes, because the first starting 128 bytes can be accessed with the help of directly addressable internal data memory. For example, if I write unsigned int IDATA z, in this declaration it declares the variable z in the memory indirectly addressable internal data memory, that is from 80 to FF. It declares the variable z above 80 memory location and within FF memory location. Whereas in the previous case, it declares the variable z, or it stores the variable z in the memory location in the range of 00 to FFH. Next, we have bit addressable internal data memory. So within the RAM, that is from 20 to 2F memory location, 16 bytes of memory is used as a bit addressable area. If you want to access that with the help of embedded C program, we should use the memory type as BData. If you want to access the SFR address, that is from 80 to FF, so we should use the memory type IDATA. If you want to access the memory, RAM memory, that is from 00 to 7F, we should use the memory type as data. So bit addressable internal data memory supports both bit and byte access. It not only allows to access bit by bit, it also allows to access byte of data. This memory is directly accessed using 8-bit address and is on-chip bit addressable RAM. Variables declared with bit addressable data type are bit addressable and may read and written using bit instructions. In assembly level language, for example, if I write SETB set bit 20H, SETB 20H, this instruction makes bit addressable memory location 20H is equal to 1, SETB 20H. Similarly, CLC clear 20H, this instruction makes 20th memory location 0. In the same way, in embedded C, if you want to access such bit addressable memory locations, if you want to declare only bit memory locations, we can use memory type as bit addressable data memory, that is BData. Example, bit BData nbit. Nbit is the variable name, that is user defined variable name. So bit is the bit data type, that is to inform the compiler that we are declaring bit variable, bit sized variable. So B data, it is to inform the compiler that it has to declare in bit addressable data memory, declares a bit variable n bit that resides in bit addressable memory location, that is 20 to 2FH. Next one is X data. Here A is missing. X data, external data. The memory type external data is used to specify that variable has to be reside in external data memory. External data memory. We all know that for an 8051 microcontroller, we can connect up to 64 kilobytes of external memory. 64 kilobytes of external memory. So if you used external memory, that is 64 kilobyte memory is connected. That external data memory can be used to store code as well as data. That can be used to store program as well as user data. Whereas code memory, internal code memory is used to store only program. Internal data memories are used to store only data, but external data memory can be used as both RAM as well as RAM. Its address as usual ranges from 0000 to 4FH. In assembly level language, use the code MOVX A, at DPTR. This instruction reads the content of external memory, which is pointed by data pointer register, and loads it into or copies it into the register A. That is, it transfers data. So in order to inform compiler that it has to store variables in external data memory, here we have to write like this: char character data type x data external data memory. So here I am using my variable, my data communication. So the similar declarations we had written even for data memory type. So here I had written x data. So it stores the word communication in the external data memory, not in the internal data memory. So we can make use of internal data memory for fast accessing applications, or in order to increase the speed of some developments or applications. Next we have pdata, paged external data memory. So paged, P stands for paged external data memory, and this segment is within 256 bytes of external data. If we use the memory type pdata is used to specify that variable has to reside within 256 bytes of external memory. The starting 256 bytes of external memory will be used as paged data, paged external data. So next, let us understand memory models. So far we understood how to specify type of memory in embedded C. If I write code, the data or variable will be declared in code memory. If I write data, it will be stored in internal directly addressable data memory. If I use IDATA, it stores the variable in indirectly addressable internal data memory, that is from the memory location 80 to FFH. If I use the memory type as BData, it stores the user defined variable in bit addressable internal memory. Now let us understand memory models. Memory model determines the default memory type. So far we discussed variable X can be made to reside in code memory, variable Y can be made to reside in data memory, and variable Z can be made to reside in external data memory. I can make use of all the different memories with the help of memory types, what we discussed so far. But we have memory models. If you use memory models, we can make all the variables to reside in one specific memory. Say for example, small, compact, and large. These are the three memory models. The memory model determines the default memory type to use variables and function arguments that include no explicit memory type. In the last three classes, we were not written memory type. So in such case, the variables were declared in internal data memory. Similarly, we have memory models. So this memory model allows to use default memory type if we have not included explicit memory type. They are small, compact, and large. Now let us understand what is the default memory for memory model small. In this model, all variables will be declared in internal data memory. If I use the model small, all variables, whatever I am going to declare as integer or character or unsigned integer, unsigned character, and so on, all those variables will be declared in internal data memory as if they were declared explicitly using data memory type specifier. data memory type. The small model data access is fastest because the direct memory access is used on chip RAM, but it is limited to 128 bytes. So as I said earlier, so if you use internal data, so internal data memory is within the controller or within the hardware, so the memory access speed will increase. The access time is very less. So this is the main advantages of using small model. So we have to use the small memory model in case if any application or program which needs to be executed quickly. So if the execution speed must be very high, then we should use small model. We should not use compact or large model. So we should make use of small model because it makes use of or it allows all the variables to reside in internal data memory. In this memory model, variable access is very efficient. So next one is compact model. In this model, all variables, here we are using this model without declaring memory type. So in this model, all variables are allocated in a single page, 256 bytes of external data memory. That is nothing but if you use this compact model, it is similar to using memory type P data. So P data is paged external data memory. It allows all the variables to reside in first 256 bytes of external memory. So similar to that, we can make use of compact model. If I write compact model, so it allows all the variables by default, it allows all the variables to declare in the first 256 bytes of external memory. The limitation is due to addressing scheme used, which is indirect through registers R0 and R1. So in assembly level language, for an indirect addressing mode, we were using two registers R0 and R1. Here the limitation, as we stated there itself, the limitation is the R0 value can only ranges from 00 to 255. That is, the maximum range is 256 only. This memory model is not as efficient as small model. Why? Because this memory model, if you use compact model, so it accesses the external memory. So the access time of external memory is more compared to internal data memory. So that's why it is not as efficient as small model, and variable access is not as fast as small model. However, the compact model is faster than large model. Compact model is faster than large model, but slower than small model. Let us take large model. So in this large model, all variables reside in external data memory, which may be up to 64 kilobytes. This is same as if they were explicitly declared using X data memory type specifier. In the memory type, if you declare all the variables by making use of memory type X data, that is similar to writing the program by making use of large model. Here, in order to access external memory, we use DPTR to point the address. Instruction set is not optimized for this memory model, so it needs more code than small or compact model to manipulate with the variables. In case if you use large model, so it is not optimized for this memory, hence it makes more code or it generates large code. So now we discussed three different models, and these three different models can be used instead of declaring variables with memory type specifier. Instead of saying the variable X is must reside in internal data memory, Y is residing in code memory, and Z is residing in external data memory or different memory. So simply if I use this word small, compact or large, it allows all the variables to reside either in internal data memory or in external starting 256 bytes of memory or in the external memory. So next, let us understand how do we write this kind of programs. So in order to write or in order to make use of this model in embedded C, we have to use hash pragma hash pragma. So if I use hash as pragma small, small as a starting line of program, as a starting line of program, it makes all the variables declared within that memory to reside in internal data memory. If I use hash pragma compact, that makes all the variables written within that program to reside in first 256 bytes of external data memory. If I write hash pragma large, it makes all the variables within that program, without mentioning the memory type, to reside in external data memory. So it completes memory models. So we understood what are all the different types of memory. So if different types of memory used in 8051C, you have to explain there are two types of memory, code memory and data memory. So in data memory, again, we can classify it into internal data, indirectly addressable internal data, bit addressable data memory, and external data memory, and paged external data memory. Memory models, you have to explain only small model, compact model, and large model. So next, let us move on to array. So in the previous classes, we had used actually array also. I didn't cover these topics, so I am brushing these topics. An array is a collection of values of same data types. Array is a collection of values of same data types. For example, int a square bracket 10. So earlier I had told, if you declare int x, the compiler makes a reserves int x. If I say int x, it reserves 16-bit memory and names it as x. In case if I write character y, it reserves byte of, this is byte off of this, byte of memory and names it as y. If I write int a of 10, it reserves 10 memory locations of each of 16 bit, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, 5, etc., 10. It reserves 10 memory location, each of 16 bit width, and names it as A. For all 10 memory location, it has given the name A, but here it has given the name X for a single memory, 16-bit single memory, because we have declared this as a variable. Here we have declared this as a array. For example, character X 10. So this data type or this array reserves 10 bytes of memory location. Why it reserves bytes of memory location? Because data type is character. It reserves 10 words of memory location. Word means 16-bit. It reserves 10 words of memory location and names it as A. For example, if I take A of 0, it reserves 5 memory location. And each memory location can be accessed, individual memory can be accessed with their index. That is A of 0, A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, A of 4, and so on. There are two types of array. One is single dimensional array, another one is two dimensional array. So single dimensional array is written like this. Example, A of 5. So this array has 5 values. Here 5 is reserve 5 memory locations, 5 memory location, and for all 5 memory location together, it has to give the name A. For example, if I write A of 5 is equal to square floor bracket of 2 comma 4 comma 5 comma 7 comma 8, then it reserves 5 such memory location and stores the value 2, 4, 5, 7, and 8 in a successive memory location, that is in the starting memory it stores 2, the next memory 4, and so on. Next, it is just like apartments. Declaring variable is like single house. It is single house. It is like an apartment. For an apartment, normally we give single name, but it has multiple flats. Next, two-dimensional array. Example, B of 2, 3. It is a two-dimensional array. Array B of 2, 3 has two values, each of which are 3-byte length. Each of which are 3-byte length. That is, it reserves two rows to two memory. It reserves two memory, so each of which are 3-byte length. Similarly, this, it has two row, this is 1, this is 2, and 3 columns, 1, 2, 3. Each row can hold 3 variables, and there are 2 such rows. So for that we have to make use of 2-dimensional array. So all this you have studied in C program, still I am repeating it. Next, string is an array of characters. The major difference between string and array is, if you are using it as a string, then we should reserve one extra byte to indicate that is the last element of string. For example, unsigned character I of 6. Here I is an array, it holds 6 memory, but here I have used only hello, hello. It has only 5 letters. Why I have taken 6? Why I am reserving 6 memory? Because I have to store 0 here. I must add 0 to indicate that this is the end of the string. While processing string instructions, we must add one extra byte in order to indicate that is the end of the string. So next, let us understand pointers used in embedded C. It is similar to C program. It is same as C program only. So before understanding usage of pointers in embedded C, let us understand the need of pointers. In indirect addressing, we use the registers R0, R1, and data pointer are used as a memory pointers. For example, move A, comma at R0. Move A, comma at R0. What does it do? This instruction reads indirectly addressable internal data memory, which is pointed by register R0 into the accumulator. Here we are using register, here I have written move R0 comma has 40, move A comma at R0. So what does it do? This first instruction loads immediate data 40 to the register R0. Next I am writing move A comma at R0. So this instruction transfers content of memory pointed by register R0 is pointing to the memory location 40. So the content of memory 40, the content of memory 40 is 78. After the execution of this instruction, accumulator will be copied with 78. What is the advantages of using this indirect addressing? So in indirect addressing, we are using the register R0 as a pointer. Say for example, if I want to load 10 successive memory locations, 10 successive memory locations, some data, similar data. I want to load 78 starting from memory location 40 up to 50. I want to load the same data. So if I want to load 78 to all these memory locations starting from 40 to 50, and if I write immediate instruction like move 40 comma has 78, move 41 comma has 78, move 42 comma has 78. So I have to write 10 instructions. Instead, if I use indirect addressing, that is a pointer, I can make use of looping. I can make looping is possible if you use indirect addressing. Looping is possible. So here you can write, if you, even if you don't use indirect addressing, you can load 10 bytes of data, immediate data, to the memory locations by repeatedly writing the same instruction. But if you want to load for around 100 bytes of data or 1000 bytes of data, so then it is highly impossible to write 1000 similar line of instructions or 100 lines of instructions. In such situation, we use indirect addressing. Similarly, for external memory. For that reason, we require pointer. In indirect addressing, registers R0, R1, and DTP data pointer are used as a memory pointers. In indirect addressing, it helps to access successive memory locations successively. Successive memory location 40, 41, 42, 43, and so on. Simply, we can increment register R0 to point the next memory. If I just increment the pointer, it points to the successive memory locations. So that's why we require pointer. In embedded C, we use pointer variable to access the data variable. So example, int star p is equal to ampersand i. If I use star and ampersand, these two must be used together. So here star p is also a variable, I is also a variable. This is the pointer initialization. The variable p holds the address of variable I. P holds the address of variable I. So it is just like move R0 comma 40H. It is similar to move R0 comma 40H. So R0 holds the address of memory. Here P holds the address of variable I. So in pointer, we have two types. One is typed pointers. Another one is untyped pointers. So first let us understand what is typed pointer. In a typed pointers always include memory type specification in the pointer declaration and always refers to a specific memory area. For example, here you can see character data star str. Here I am using pointer variable str and also I am writing data. So this data is a memory type. This is a data type. So I am specifying memory type where the data variable is residing, where the data is storing. For example, this is the memory. Here it holds data. This is the memory, it holds the address of data. Address of data. So here I am in a typed pointer, I am specifying data is stored in internal data memory. Internal data memory. So if I write character X data, it specifies data is stored in external data memory. External data memory. What is the usage of, what is the advantages of typed pointer? So in a typed pointer, we specify memory type. Specify memory type. So if you specify memory area, the code generated for typed pointer will execute more quickly. Why? Because the compiler knows from which memory it has to access the data during compiling time only. So during compiling time, it will come to know that it has to refer internal data memory. It has to refer internal data memory. So hence, since it will come to know that it has to access internal data memory during the compile time only, so it executes more quickly. The compiler can use this information to optimize memory access. If execution speed is more important, priority. It is more important in any program or in any applications. Then we should use typed pointer, because in a typed pointer, so we are going to specify memory type where data is residing and where address is residing, where pointer variable is residing and where the variable is residing. Here I is variable and P is pointer variable, where P is residing and I is residing is specified in case of typed pointer. While declaring itself, we are going to write that. Whereas in case of untyped pointer, in an untyped pointer, we don't use data memory type. Data memories are not explicitly specified. In an untyped pointer, data memory is not explicitly specified. For example, character star s. Here, in this case, I am not writing memory type. If I am not using memory type, then it is untyped pointer. Here I have used star, it refers pointer variable. But in the previous case, here I have used variable along with pointer, as well as I have written memory type. So in case, in an untyped pointer are always stored using 3 bytes, whereas typed pointer takes 1 or 2 bytes. What is the reason is, the first byte, compiler reserves first byte to store the informations like where it is declaring this variable, whether it is declaring internal data memory, whether it is declaring in external data memory, whether it is declaring in code memory. So in order to have actual path or the information, it reserves first byte, it reserves one byte. For example, the first byte is for the memory type. First byte holds either 01 02 03 04 05. So if it is 01, it indicates that variable is residing in indirectly addressable internal data memory. If first byte is 02, it indicates that the variable is pointer variable is residing in external data memory. So if first byte is 3, it indicates that it is in first 256 bytes of external data memory, and so on. And the next 2 bytes is used as higher order bytes of offset, and third byte is for lower order byte of offset. That is the variable is actually refers to 16 bit address. If it is a integer type, the variable actually refers to 16 bit address. That 16 bit address is stored as a second and third byte, and the first byte holds in which memory it is declaring. The compiler reserves first byte to store that information. So it occupies 3 bytes of memory location, whereas typed pointer occupies only 1 or 2 byte of memory location. And in untyped pointer, since compiler will not be knowing where it is storing the data during the compilation itself, during the compiling time, so it takes more time to execute the untyped pointer variables or untyped pointer declaration. The code generated for an untyped pointer will execute more slowly. Executes more slowly than the equivalent code generated for typed pointer, because it is slow, because it has to understood, it has to decode in which memory it is storing that variable. So after decoding that, it has to access that particular memory. This is because the memory area is not known until runtime. So the particular memory will be known during the runtime only. If execution speed is priority, you should use typed pointer instead of untyped pointer. So we have understood what is pointer and how do we use pointers in embedded C, and also we discussed what is typed pointer and what is untyped pointer. In typed pointer, we write memory type, and in untyped pointer, we don't write memory types. Typed pointer takes less time to execute, untyped pointer takes more time to execute. Typed pointer occupies few memory, whereas untyped pointer occupies more memory. 2 or more bytes are required. So next, let us understand one program which was not discussed in the previous class. So that is, write a program to convert hexadecimal number FDX to decimal and display the digits on port 0, port 1 and port 2. So I have to convert hexadecimal number into decimal. So along with this, I will explain arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators are plus, minus, and then star for multiplication, and division for division, that is percentage symbol, and bar. This is, sorry, bar is division operator, percentage is modulation operator. This is modulation operator. Modulation, this is division. So similar to, this is addition, this is subtraction, this is multiplication. So I will include these different arithmetic operator in this program and I will explain. So now we have to convert hexadecimal number FD into decimal. So in order to understand this program, you might have studied in assembly level language also, but still I would like to explain it. Now let us take an hexadecimal number equivalent to decimal. So what is hexadecimal number? I will take FD only. The equivalent decimal value is equal to FF is 255, FE is 254, FD is 253. This is decimal equivalent of hexadecimal, 253. So I have to extract 2, 5 and 3. So what I have to do, I have to divide the hexadecimal number FD from 10. If I divide the hexadecimal number FD from 10, so if I divide 253 by 10, so 253 by 10, 10 25 is 250. So here I am writing in decimal so that you can easily understand. So 253 minus 250, it will be 3. So I successfully extracted digit 3. This is over. Next, here I got the quotient as 25. So the 25 has to be separated as 2 and 5. In order to separate it as 2 and 5, what I have to do? I have to divide again it by 10. If I divide again it by 10, 10 2s are 20. So the remainder is 5. Now I was able to extract all the digits 5, 2, 3. So I have to order them properly to get 253. So microcontroller or a microprocessor will not divide 253 by 10. Microcontroller divides FD by 10. But for your convenience, that is to make you to understand, I am dividing 253 by 10. So I am explaining this in decimal. Now we have separated digits 5, 2 and 3. So how we separated? We separated these digits by dividing that number by 10, and we got remainder and another one is quotient. So in order to separate the quotient again, in a quotient it consisting of two digits, in order to separate it again, I have to divide again by 10. So now I will explain the program. Unsigned character x comma binary byte d1 d2 d3. So here binary byte is nothing but hexadecimal number. I am using D1, D2, D3 to store decimal digits 2, 5, 3. and I may be using some extra variable as x, so that you will come to know after explaining this. Binary byte is x. Now I am binary byte to 10 dividing this. So if you use this division operator, you will get quotient only, not the remainder. So after dividing fd by 10 by making use of this operator, result will be only quotient. So it does not give you remainder. So 25 will be stored to register x, sorry, variable x. So 25 is stored to x. Now I want to extract 3 also. So in order to get 3, what I have to do? I have to divide. But division operator does not give. So I am making use of modulus operator. Modulus operator also performs the same thing, that is division, but it returns remainder. Division operator performs division, it returns only quotient. So this is the difference between division and modulus operator. Modulus operator returns remainder. So d1 holds with 3. After the execution of this instruction, d1 will have 3. So next, the variable x is having 25. So now what I have to do? I have to divide this also by 10. So I am dividing. D2 is equal to x modulus 10. Why I am using modulus here again? Because it gives remainder. After 2, I have to extract 5. Sorry, after 3, I have to extract 3. So for that reason, I am making use of modulus operator to divide 25 by 10 again. So x modulus 10. So it gives remainder will be 5. Next, I am using x. Variable x holds 25, d3 is equal to 25 divided by 10. So if you use division operator, it gives quotient. So quotient 2 will be stored to d3. So d3 will holds 2, d2 holds 5, and d1 holds 3. 2, 5, 3 is the equivalent decimal value of for fd. So I am sending that to different ports. Port 0 is equal to 0 d1, port 1 is equal to 0 0 5, and port 2 is equal to 0 2. First time sending lower byte, that is 0 3, next time sending 0 5, next time sending 0 2. So now if you want to display this in numerical that is display devices, what we have to do, we have to convert this into ASCII equivalent, and then we have to send. Okay, so that is extra thing. So this completes this program, hexadecimal to decimal. Now let us quickly go through the different question papers. So here it is April-May 2017. So in this chapter it is covering explain 8051 C data types. In the part B, write 8051 C program to convert unpacked BCD to ASCII and display it on P0. We have discussed it. Next, 8051 program to toggle all the bits of port 0 for every 300 millisecond. We have discussed. Write C program to read P1.2 and send it to P2.3 after inverting it. Explain the different bit-wise. It is a wire. It has to be bit-wise. Bit-wise logical operators available in 8051C. So here 20 marks, here 5, 25. So next, tabulate basic data types, their size and range supported in embedded C. So here you have to write a table indicating data types, their size and range, that is character, unsigned character, signed character, unsigned integer, signed integer, and so on. In their range, 8-bit, 16-bit, -128 to +127, and so on. Next year, write an embedded C program to convert unpacked BCD digits to ASCII. C program to read P1.2 and send it to P2.3 after inverting it. Write a C program to toggle all the bits of port 0 for every 500 millisecond. Mention different logical operators available in C. Logical operators we discussed in the last class. In the next question paper, write a C program to read P1.2 and send it to P2.3 after inverting it. Explain different data types available in 8051C. Write a C program to convert ASCII to packed BCD and display it on port P1, it should be port. List any three advantages and any two disadvantages using 8251C. We discussed. Next here, write C statements to do the following tasks. Here, just you have to write the statements to mask D3 and D5 bits of port 0. Third and fifth bits of port 0 has to be masked. While explaining logical OR operator, I explained it. So you have to make use of logical and operand ampersand to toggle D7 and D3 bits of port 2. So you have to toggle D7 and D3 bits of port 2. So here you can make use of XOR operator or NOT operator. Write a C program to convert unpacked BCD to ASCII again. 8251C program to convert ASCII digits to BCD again. List the advantages and disadvantages of 8251C. Explain different data types available in 8251C. So here in this question paper, here 10 marks, 20, 30, 35 marks. So in April, May 2018, you got from this chapter for around 35 marks. List the advantages of embedded C, write C program. Here, different memory models, explain different data types available. So all the topics are covered. So thank you.